Proper fiber management between two or more enhanced management frames allows you to eliminate congestion and enables quick and easy connections. Before beginning this procedure, you must follow a few simple guidelines. When routing the jumpers to adjacent frames, use a length of 22.5 feet, plus 5 feet for every additional frame passed. Start the jumper routing in the frame with the heaviest fiber load, or the source frame. Place the slack in the frame with the least fiber load, or the destination frame. Always use troughs to transition between frames and route the fiber under a transition spool as fiber enters or leaves a frame. Always route fiber under the transition hub at the bottom when entering or leaving a frame. Determine which trough to use by following the recommendations provided in the attached booklet or by the labels on the spool ends. By adhering to the following step-by-step instructions, you should be able to cleanly route fiber, reducing congestion between two EMF frames. First, pull the modules to be connected forward to the stopped position. Press the buttons on each side of the module to drop the handle. Next, remove the dust caps from the termination point adapter and the connector. Clean connector and adapter per standard company practices or as described in Corning Cable Systems Standard Recommended Procedure 003580. Now you're ready to connect the jumpers to the module located on the most densely loaded frame. Possible connections and suggested routing paths are shown here. Once the jumpers are connected, raise the handle in the source frame and push the jumpers down into the handle routing fins. Be sure to route the jumpers around the side of the module and up over the side guide. Route the jumpers loosely under the transition spool on the same side of the intrabay unit, or IBU, closest to the module, up through the opening into a trough, and lay it along the trough to the destination frame. To achieve optimal slack storage, move the jumper cord up or down to a different trough or to a higher or lower IBU spool on the destination frame. Please note, if the jumper must pass overhead to cross an aisle or other passageway, route it up through the top of the IBU in the center of the frame as shown here. Next, insert the end of the jumper through to the front of the frame on the side of the IBU, opposite from the destination module where the jumper will be connected. Route the jumper under the transition spool up over a center spool on the IBU and down under the second transition spool. Select the highest center spool that the jumper will reach without pulling on the jumper. Be careful to again route the jumper over the side guide and remember to clean the adapter and connector per your company's standard practices or following Corning's Standard Recommended Procedure 003580. Finally, close both the source and destination modules. Dress the jumper in both frames so it lies neatly with the other jumpers. The enhanced management frame and supporting products are yet another example of how Corning Cable Systems provides solutions for the needs of today's customers. If you have any questions, please contact your local sales representative or Corning Cable Systems customer service at 1-800-743-2671.